In this tutorial, we'll guide you in creating a league table and designing graphics for tabular data using tile and table text objects. These tools help set up scenes efficiently and save time populating data. WASP provides add-ins for importing data from various sources, enabling filtering, sorting, and pagination. Columns can be wired to graphical elements. We'll also show how to import 3D objects from software like Maya, Max, and Blender into WASP. To begin, let's create a background texture. Press F6 to access the texture pool. Texture pool is the container for all textures in scene. You can create and import various kinds of images and disk videos and live videos in your design. Click on the required texture type to open the image import dialog and select one or multiple images to import to your design scene. Here we are applying the background of the scene. So, the selected image is applied as source texture on the background. The tile tool helps you set up data neatly in a grid or table. Start by creating a cube. Adjust dimensions and round corners by tweaking chamfer radius and segments for the cube. Now take a tile. Pick the cube as the source object. As the cube is only for reference and not a part of our design, let's hide it. Specify the depth and height. And define the number of rows and columns. Set the horizontal and vertical grout to set the spacing between the tiles. Navigate to row column selection. Pick the columns you want to resize together. Then right-click and enter the value. Modify the colors of table columns by accessing the color segment in table data. To merge the columns, right-click and check on Fuse Columns. You can customize the tile material. Now let's animate the tile. Enable the Auto key. Adjust the opacity to 100. Place keys on the timeline for position and rotation at by simply clicking on the values. A key is automatically generated at frame 0. Proceed to frame 0 and adjust the tile's position and rotation values. Let's animate the tile effect now. Click on Animate Tile and explore the various animation styles available. If you enable local transformation, each tile will animate around its center. Change the overlap value to adjust the timing between the two keyframes. Set the overlap value at the end frame also. Deactivate the auto key and cue and play the animation or manually scrub through the timeline to check. Now let's wire text and sprite to tile with table text. WASP3D makes it easy to connect table text to data using data add-ins. These add-ins pull data from sources like Excel, Google Sheets, XML, and JSON for file-based data inputs, SQL, Postgres, MySQL for database imports, and ODBC for other databases and files. With a simple drag-and-drop process, you can import and link the data to the graphic. You can know more about each add-in using the help documentation in the software and user manual. To create table text, double-click the icon. Choose Tile 1 as source object. In this example, we're using Excel as the data source. Press F8 to access the variable sheet. The variable sheet window lists several types of variables that can be accessed within different scope ranges at runtime. From the data menu, get the Excel add-in. Browse and select the Excel file. The Excel add-in reads data from an Excel file in the same table format, allowing users to link graphic data. It supports connecting data from CSV and TXT files, and you can filter and sort your data within the add-in. Set rows per page to 10, matching the 10 rows in design. To obtain the top 10 teams, apply filter in descending order based on their points. We will now add image sprite in table text. A sprite image is a single graphic image that combines multiple smaller images into one larger image. Press F6 for the texture pool and import the sprite texture. Right-click on the sprite texture and select Convert to Sprite. In the parametric section, specify the rows and columns of the sprite. In Table Text Parameters, click on Table Data. That will open the table layout where you can modify the text properties and wire the Excel. Drag Sheet 1 onto the columns. Select the data input for each column in the Table Data section according to Excel format. Modify fonts and sizes. Changing the default column will affect all columns simultaneously. Override color will replace any material or text color with the table text color. Tweaking properties for individual columns only affects those specific columns. In the sprite column, select your sprite texture. Click on Preview to preview your changes and press OK to confirm. Now, check on the wire tile option in the table text to connect the text with the tile animation. After adjusting the text font and alignment within the table layout, the basic design is good to go. Let's enhance the design by creating a header. To do this, select Tile and Table Layers and group them by pressing Ctrl plus G. Make a duplicate copy of the grouped layers. Take Tile 2 as a source object in Table Text. Adjust the header height and reduce the number of rows. Press F8 to open the variable sheet and create another Excel data variable. Open the same Excel file. Set rows per page to 1 and uncheck Use First Row as Column. Now select Table Text 2 and go to Table Data. Drag Excel 2 onto the columns and right-click on the drop-down to choose the selected columns. Apply None to the first four columns and continue with the next column. Select the tile, go to Row Column Selection, and modify the color of the tile. The design is ready with the addition of subheader, main header, and logo. For reflection, we use a combination of render texture, floor object, and a deflector plane. Render texture generates a real-time render of the selected objects. The floor object can be a rectangle or a cube, which would serve as the floor in the design. And the deflector plane is used to calculate the point and angle of reflection. Start by creating a rectangle. Now, take a deflector plane. Position deflector plane in the same location as the rectangle. Or you can drag and drop transformation values from one object to another. Now go to Material Editor by pressing F5 and create a uniform material. Take a render texture from the Texture Pool panel. Change texture mode to Mirror. In the Parametric Settings, enable Reflection and choose the Deflector Plane as the Mirror Plane. To add material to the object, either right-click on the material and choose Set Material to Object or drag and drop the material onto the object. Now, adjust the opacity and MIP level to add a blur to the reflection and enhance its realism. Activate render texture only for the objects that need to be reflected. Let's move on to creating cloth. This is a 3D primitive tool. It's handy for making cloth animations and adding special effects using attributes like gravity, wind, and guide. Double-click to create a cloth. Change the cloth's pivot. Modify the horizontal and vertical segments for a smoother cloth simulation. Fine-tune the cloth dynamics to achieve the results. Import the texture for the flag and apply it on Material Stage 1. duplicate it and place it on the other side of the table. Go to Scene Queue to see the updated cloth alignment. Now let's see how we can add 3D elements in the scene. You can import the FBX, CalADA, or 3DM files created in any 3D modeling software. User can texture these files and import them with baked textures with their UVW coordinates. Import your FBX by clicking on the FBX button in the object pool. Once you have made your selection, a dialog box will appear where you can see all the import options available, such as the standard material and uniform material options. Choose the standard material for added depth and shadows, and the uniform material for flat surfaces. Select Collapse Hierarchy to get the whole FBX model as one object. In the default UV, keep the UV channel of the baked textures same number as it was in your 3ds Max or any other 3D software that was used. Change its pivot point to base. Turn off Inherit Parent to allow independent rotation of the FBX from the default timeline. Add a Go to command to loop from the last frame back to zero for an infinite loop. Now take material from the library. And apply on all the sub-objects.